I've had several questions recently about what to do in the recovery interval when you're doing repetition type workouts. Should you worry about pace? Should it be about heart rate? How you feel? How fast should you go? Should you stand still? Several questions related to this period where you're recovering between repetitions. Now, my general rule, which I think works really well as kind of everything in a nutshell, is jog if you can, walk if you must, never stand still for very long at a time. That covers it in general, but let's talk about some more specific examples. So there are three different types of training zones where you may have repetitions. The first is the stamina zone. So if you see tempo intervals or cruise intervals, those are stamina zone workouts. They're meant to improve your lactate threshold. So when you are doing repetition workouts, like tempo intervals or cruise intervals, the recovery interval should be a jog. It shouldn't, those repeats should not feel so fast that you feel that you have to walk. You typically can jog those. And the way I think about how to distribute your effort across those workouts is think about the races that fit into that stamina zone. So the stamina zone, you can think about, okay, how would a race feel that lasts between 45 minutes and an hour and a half? So for many people, that's a 10K to a half marathon. That usually captures most people. So think about how you would feel across that race. And in general, you feel sort of easy, medium effort in the beginning. So that's what you should feel for your first few repetitions. And then medium to medium hard in the middle repetitions. So that's how you should feel coming off that recovery jog for those middle repetitions. And then medium hard to hard for the final few repetitions. So with that in mind, you can adjust how quickly you jog on your recovery interval to know that you're appropriately recovered. So if you're jogging too quickly and you're getting so tired that those last few repeats feel like a race, they feel very, very hard, then you're going too quickly on the recovery interval. On the other hand, if you feel really easy through the entire workout, that would indicate you're not going quick enough on your recovery interval. I hope that makes sense. It really comes down to changing how you execute that recovery interval so you feel appropriate on the repetitions. As I mentioned, I like to think about it as how should I feel at this part of a race that's in that zone. So here's another example. If you do a speed workout or a hill workout, you should feel like how does a race between, say, 10 to 30 minutes. So for most people, that's a mile up to 10K for some really fast runners, but something mile, 5K, 10K, that's kind of how you want to feel across that workout. And as a result, you can adjust your how you perform in the recovery interval to feel appropriate. So for those types of workouts, it's usually the first few repetitions are at a medium effort. The middle are kind of medium hard. The last few are hard to very hard in those speed workouts and hill workouts. So you can adjust if you jog, if you walk, how quickly you perform in the recovery interval. And then finally, if you have a sprint workout, that's the other zone where you can have repetitions with this recovery jog. Those are obviously like something really fast, like less than 10 minutes racing, which is a mile or 800 meters for most people. So that's where it's sort of hard to start for the first few repetitions. It's a hard effort. And then you have a slow recovery jog. And then you have very hard by the time you get to the final repetition. So for me, I don't worry about pace during the recovery interval. I don't worry about heart rate. I typically worry more about my effort and breathing, because those two tied together make up how I should feel across the workout. So again, I like to take that recovery interval and think about how tired should I be, how much effort should I need to put into the next repetition, as a guide for that recovery interval. If I'm doing a cruise interval workout and I should be feeling kind of a medium effort in those middle repetitions, but it's feeling medium hard already, I know I need to slow down my recovery interval so that I recover a little bit more and I feel a little bit fresher for that next repeat. Likewise, if I'm doing a speed workout and I'm feeling really good going into those last few repeats, my breath is completely recovered and I have no lactic acid buildup and I'm really fresh for those final few repeats, I probably didn't run the recovery intervals fast enough early in the workout. I needed to be more tired toward the end. So I hope that helps sort of clear off some of the confusion about the recovery interval. I feel like don't worry about your pace. Don't worry about your heart rate. Just worry about your effort in breathing on those repetitions. As long as it flows with how you should feel for that type of zone workout, again, kind of stamina zones, easy, medium, 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 hard, speed workouts already starting at medium, then getting hard, and then very hard at the end, and sprint workouts hard to very hard. So if you think of it across effort, I think it helps you adjust your recovery interval. As always, if that gets you more confused, please let me know, and I'm happy to answer any questions you have. Take care, and I'll talk to you again real soon.